$2,500, huh? Well, I had no idea bartenders made that kind of money. Maybe I'm in the wrong line of business, Cheryl. What do you think?
Well, maybe you should just bug off. What do you think?
Who's your friend?
Someone you're better off not knowing.
Why don't you mind your own business?
Anything that concerns Dawn is my business, Decker.
I don't think so. Not anymore.
You know, why do I get the distinct feeling that Dawn's not going to see a penny of that money? Hmm?
You ready?
Yes, I am ready.
Let's go.
All right.
Are you all right?
No.
I take it that was...
Yeah. That was Dawn and Decker.
Well, I don't know what she sees in him.
Yeah, well, he's got her conned right now. But you know what? I'm going to see to it that she finds out what he really is.
Say, Lucy, anytime I see you, you're always pacing around. Is that some kind of prenatal exercise?
Why do you keep popping over here? What is it with you? You just keep showing up.
Because I like you. And I want to finish our discussion, you know, about Victor Jerome's heirs coming forth and claiming those diamonds.
We don't need to finish that discussion because there aren't any heirs.
Yeah, well, let's just say that a few of them did. Where would that leave you? Well, since you asked, I'll tell you. In a loveless marriage carrying your ex-boyfriend's baby.
I am in a perfect marriage. And for the 900th time, I am carrying Alan's baby.
Oh, yeah. Come on, let's go. Let's go get a blood test. We're fine. Let's go do this.
Just wait. Shut up, okay? Someone is coming. Just be quiet.
Don't let me stifle your need to, you know, eavesdrop here.
I don't eavesdrop. I don't care who they are or what they're saying.
Sounds a little bit like Alan and Monica.
There's no reason for you to leave, Monica. It's only because of the stupid attempt on the part of Lucy to buy the house from you.
Look, you should be staying here to protect your investment anyway. Besides that, you're still recuperating.
I don't want to cause trouble.
You're not causing any trouble.
But I just don't want to have another scene with Lucy.
I lived with you long enough to know that I can't change your mind. Will you at least let me help you get moved?
No, thank you very much, but I've called a cab. You should be here. And I want to thank you very much for letting me stay.
You're welcome.
Goodbye.
I'll see you out.
Well, so much for your perfect marriage.
I still can't believe Dawn hasn't seen through that guy.
Well, sometimes people see what they want to see.
Yeah, well, she better see through him pretty soon or she could be making the biggest mistake of her life.
Hello, Ned.
Cheryl.
Hi,
Kay.
Oh, hi. Hi, I'm really glad you're giving your welcome to ELQ party here.
Well, I'm glad that you're getting the business, but I still think it's an awfully big fuss.
Well, it's too late now. Do you like champagne, by the way?
Actually, I don't really drink.
Well, I do happen to have a case of something very special that I normally don't even put on the wine list, and I would like to offer it to you for your party.
Well, that's very sweet, but it's not necessary.
I wouldn't do it if I didn't want to. You understand?
I do. And thank you.
You're welcome. Enjoy. Ned?
Thanks. We will. See you. You know, that Kate's really a special person.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I hope I haven't been boring you with all my problems.
No. Not at all. I think sometimes it's good to hear someone else's problems because then... your own seem a little less important.
Yeah, I guess you're right. Just with that court date coming up on Friday, I just can't seem to get it out of my mind, you know?
I understand. I had a relationship that was very important to me that ended badly. It was a long time ago. Back when I was still an incurable romantic.
Robert!
it, huh? I mean, hey, he doesn't want to see me. It's freezing. I didn't have my coat. I leave it at the station.
It's just one of those days. It's just over. This is not working out right, Frisco. It really isn't. I mean, it's cold out here. I understand that. But the point is, I'm the police commissioner. And the police commissioner... What do police commissioners do these days? I mean, well, in my particular case, I'm sitting around looking for a bit of dirt on Rico Chacon, trying to talk the DA out of not busting Carla for murder one, issuing a few warrants, busting some drug deals, all that easy stuff, right? What happens? Suddenly I'm descended upon by 150 of the biggest gold bricks in town, all laying claim to Lucy Coe Quatermain, whoever she's married to this bloody week's diamonds. I mean, you should have heard some of the stories. Boy, this was wild. I mean, who was going to believe that somebody drove past and lobbed these through the window of her car and onto the front seat? Whatever happened to air conditioning, huh? Whatever happened to air conditioning?
Don't mention air conditioning.
What if she'd had air conditioning?
Mind?
If she'd had air conditioning and the windows had been up and the top had been closed, I mean, I wouldn't be dealing with this mess right now. This is not my line of work. Yeah? Agree?
Hey, you know, speaking of those diamonds...
What?
Scott Baldwin came by the station last week to look at the diamonds.
He did?
Yeah. The sergeant that was on duty said,
What did he say?
Tracy Quatermain came with him. And Lord Ashton. He brings his jewelry, Luke, too. Lord Ashton does. You think maybe,
Ashton? Quatermain. I bet those three idiots placed this ad in the paper. I mean, I am... Those Quatermains burn me, I tell you, really.
Am I not using the word burn? I mean, have a little courtesy here. You know, it's
cold.
October. I don't have my coat.
Why aren't you wearing a coat? You can get cold out here. If you're cold, why didn't you say so? We could have gone inside. Come on. Come on. You want my coat? You want my coat? Come on. I'll buy you a beer. Maybe an ice cream. Come on. I'm just wondering what the kid's gonna call me.
Inmate 623-5.
All right. So, you and Alan are really going to Cheryl's party, huh?
Well, it is a social occasion, so of course we are.
Okay. How about we have a little drink while we're waiting?
No way, absolutely not. What are you, stupid? You don't offer a pregnant lady alcohol.
Boy, you're really going to be a good mother. Lucy, I love the way you're taking care of our kid.
It's Alan's child.
Well, yeah, as far as the trust fund's concerned.
Oh.
You know, I don't think you should be going on your condition, though. I don't.
It's fine, as long as I watch what I eat and drink.
Well, what are you going to do, hire a royal taster there, Queenie?
I don't have to. I'm going to bring my own food. Besides, I cannot wait to see you and Tracy and Ashton all together.
Why? We're here all the time.
Well, you know, Scott, it's strange, but I have this funny feeling. You do know something about that ad that was placed. And what's very funny is secrets certainly have a way of coming out, don't they?
Well, let's hope not, Lucy. Because I'm sort of dependent on it.